subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
People have to live in unity.
We are still in transition.
Civil society has been decimated.
Of course, we rely on media.
And I think the government has not done enough.
The international community has failed to respond.
No place in the world is perfect.
Yoga event is held here.
Severe injustice, and they should be stopped.
We should raise our voices.
Condemn this brutal act.
Hello viewers, I'm your host Uzma Jafri with another episode of South Asia Focus. Let's begin the show. On several occasions, Pakistan has been accused by Afghan administration of colluding with the Taliban. Kabul blames Islamabad for the rising violence and instability in Afghanistan. Pakistan, on the other side, maintains that it wants peace at its western border. It supports the Afghanistan peace process and advocates ceasefire between the two warring sides. But that's its public face and stance. Privately, it has been holding talks and meetings with the Taliban despite Kabul's reservations. Recently, Pakistan Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi hosted a Taliban delegation in Islamabad. Have a look.
Amid stalled peace talks between the warring sides of Afghan government and the Taliban, Pakistan Foreign Minister Shah Mahmood Qureshi hosted a six-member Taliban delegation in Islamabad. The meeting came in line for further strengthening a relationship which many describes as unethical and suspicious. But this wasn't the first time. Pakistan, which Kabul administration accuses of sheltering militants and helping the Taliban with the war strategies and weaponry, has hosted top insurgents on more than one occasion. A similar meeting in October last year had been condemned by Kabul. While Pakistan's relations with the insurgents have come under international lens, Islamabad justifies it as an effort to persuade the Taliban for peace. It has even issued statements that appear harmless at the surface.
हमने अहाता किया कि अक्टूबर 2019 से लेकर अब तक क्या पेशरफ्त हुई है, कहां कामयाबियां हासिल हुई हैं और अभी भी अगर कोई पेचीदगियां हैं तो वो क्या हैं और उनका हल कैसे निकल सकता है. हमने जो आपस में तबादला ख्याल किया उससे मैं पुरुमीद हूं कि इंशाल्लाह मुस्तकबिल करीब में मुश्किलात के बावजूद और इसमें कोई शक नहीं कि स्पॉयलर्स मौजूद हैं उसके बावजूद मैं पुरुमीद हूं कि रास्ता निकल सकता है. और मैंने देखा है कि उस रास्ते को हमवार करने के लिए ये ज़हनी तौर पर और कल्बी तौर पर मुझे तैयार और आमादा दिखाई देते हैं.
Its actions, however, have not been a reflection of its claims. Pakistan's role in providing safe havens to terrorists has been questioned by many countries across the world. Some observers have even held it responsible for the prolonged war in Afghanistan. They say that Pakistan doesn't want a peaceful and stable Afghanistan for its larger interest with its allies, and negotiation exercise is a deception. Pakistan might say that it has contributed to the success achieved in peace process, but international observers believe that it was the sustained US pressure, not Islamabad's meetings, that brought Taliban to the table. Taliban, on the other side, have intensified its violence across the country. Regular attacks have further hampered the peace process that suffered bottlenecks after disagreements cropped up over the release of last 320 prisoners. They are unabated. They have been killing civilians and government personnel alike. People narrating horrific tales has become an everyday incident.
امی خونشتی اون سبب مترامت پشت کلینیک و پشت دروازه اولی ما یک چهار دقیقه و پنج دقیقه چالون بود صداش می آمد اولی بعد از امی چهار پنج دقیقه دیگر انفجار شد دیگر نفع می دیم نیمی والا کشمو می بینیم نیمی والا کسی خانان کمر چپر شد مطر تخریب شد یک اعضای فامیل را سه چهار زخمی شده
Afghan administration recently announced that the talks between the two will resume in early September, a news that Taliban has denied. Taliban says it will move ahead only after the last prisoner among the remaining 320 is released. French and Australian governments have urged Kabul to not release the hardcore criminals who have killed their citizens. A mounting multi-pronged challenge has now besieged the decision-making bodies of Afghanistan. The peace process, which has made gains despite delays, has seemingly hit a roadblock with Kabul administration running out of time. And a chest-thumping Pakistan can do absolutely nothing to improve the situation.
We are now joined by Dipankar Sen Gupta, a university professor and an expert on the South Asian geopolitics. So, Mr. Sen Gupta, do you believe Pakistan has made any significant contributions to the Afghan peace process? And is it ethical if Pakistan holds meetings with the Taliban?
Look, everybody knows that Pakistan has done everything in its power to sabotage the peace process. Is it ethical for the Pakistanis to meet the Taliban or have a meeting with the Taliban? The answer is no. But the Pakistanis are disguising this or basically trying to say that they are basically contributing to building peace. And there are a lot of takers for it who know better. Because the United States wants to get out of Pakistan. It wants a face-saving way out. And it is Pakistan which is taking advantage of this particular situation to do openly what it had been doing surreptitiously, and that is why they are holding a meeting with the Taliban. The thing is to get the Americans outside Afghanistan and then to do whatever they want in Afghanistan.
Afghanistan has time and again accused Pakistan of sheltering militants and providing material support to the Taliban. Do you think Pakistan has had change of a strategy and it is backing peace now?
Pakistan is not backing peace. Pakistan is backing a strategy which will lead to its entire domination of Afghanistan polity through its proxies, the Taliban. The problem with the Afghan government is they were making charges which everybody knew to be true. But unfortunately, the Afghanistan government never got around to establishing their hold in Afghanistan either through security means or through governance. Under those circumstances, when a government is completely dependent on others for its revenues as well as its security, then after some time people tend to get tired. So while their charges are true, the inability of the Afghan government to do anything in this regard has made their charges seem irrelevant.
Moving on. As floods continue to wreak havoc in South Asia, one third of Bangladesh is now submerged deep underwater. Scores have lost their lives and millions others have been displaced as a result of a prolonged monsoon. According to the weather department, the situation will not change despite extensive evacuation and relief drives as heavy rains are expected till early September.
Towns and villages in Bangladesh are flooded, and people are forced to wade through waist-high waters. habitations are overwhelmed with water as incessant downpour has destroyed everything, from shelters to farming to livestock. People's calculations who prepared themselves in advance for the floods have gone wrong, as the monsoon spell has extended way beyond its expected phase. Thousands of optimistic Bangladeshis who believed that a brief spell could have been endured are now out of essentials. Even government relief hasn't reached the people in many areas.
বন্যা আমরা অনেক কষ্টতে আছি। এক মাস যাবতে বাজার ঘাট করতারি না, এমন কি ই করতারি না, খাওয়া দাওয়া করতারি না, পড়াশোনা কাছে অনেক লেখাপড়া করাইতারি না, অনেক বাড়ি ঘর সেরে গেছে, চলে গেছে। আমরা অনেক যাবতে অনেক কষ্ট দিই বাড়ি ঘরে।
As per the local media reports, around 170 people have died and millions have fled their homes. Around 17% of Bangladesh remains underwater throughout the year, which is needed for environmental balance in the country. But the annual flood increased the water level by 18%, thereby inundating 35% of the country. The issue resurfaces every year, but Dhaka hasn't been able to come up with a concrete and sustainable solution even now.
ডাবর যাই হোক কিছুমতে যাই হোক খাইছি আর আবার ডাবর করছি বাড়ি ছেড়ে চলে গেছি আর আবার পানি কমছে আবার বাড়তেছি এখন আবার ওই পানি সেই পানি আবার পানি বাড়তে আছে
Adapting to annual floods has been the country's key strategy and a crucial part of its policy on disaster risk reduction, but an unexpected deluge fails its plans and models. People in parts of the country where the disaster has taken a heavy toll on lives and infrastructure say that they have never seen something like this year's floods.
We were here for some talk, who cost to go see? Gorubas Grazi Zangul Dazakaisi, who be sure come cost to see Allah. Zibun de Chenericum Costamai.
Other parts of South Asia too have been severely affected by the torrential rains. Millions have been displaced. Rescue and relief operations are underway but have been able to achieve little success, as the phase is not over with prediction of more rain in the next few days, further dampening the spirit and hope of people.
Moving on. The pandemic COVID-19 is expanding rapidly in South Asia with around 4 million cases reported so far from the region. The positive, however, is that entire region has a low fatality rate. The second most populated country, India, which has conducted over 40 million tests, has a fatality rate of 1.8% and a recovery rate of 75%. The country has even started human trials of the vaccine candidate developed by the Oxford. The fight against the virus is relatively weaker in other South Asian countries, with Pakistan, Bangladesh, Afghanistan and Nepal keeping everyday testing numbers low.
Indian fight against the pandemic COVID-19 took a leap as a hospital in Pune city kicked off human trials for coronavirus vaccine. The vaccine candidate developed in Oxford University and manufactured at the Serum Institute of India gave the first doses to two volunteers. If successful, the Serum Institute, which has tied up with British-Swedish pharmaceutical firm AstraZeneca, will produce 1 billion doses under Covishield of the vaccine in the country.
Out of the five candidates, three had antibodies, so they were not eligible to take vaccine, and two who were negative for both, they have been given the vaccine. Both are males. After giving the vaccine after half an hour, If their vitals are stable, they will be going home. They will explain few things which they have to observe and report to us on our emergency numbers.
The vaccine, which has shown encouraging results, is made from a weakened version of a common cold, adenovirus, taken from chimpanzees and genetically modified. The number of coronavirus patients in India has shown a sudden spike after the government decided to open its economy. People have been backing the efforts as large number of them have volunteered for vaccine trials.
Excitement ahe ki youngster manun mi deshasathi ani asha pandemic cha situation madhi kahi tari apan karu ichito to maza aahvan ahe ki navin youngsters ne pan yavo participate karav jevde lavkar result yetil tevde lavkar market madhe vaccine yenar ani te aplya deshasathi changle ahe.
Meanwhile, Russia, which claims to have prepared the first effective response against the virus, is in talks with India for a large-scale production of its Sputnik vaccine. While India has been taking leaps towards finding a permanent solution, its fight against the virus, despite huge population, has been commended by major international organizations, including United Nations. An escalated testing has helped it find and treat more patients in time. While the country's fatality rate has come down to 1.82%, its recovery rate is over 75%. The worry, however, is with the smaller countries that have not been able to conduct enough tests. Afghanistan and Nepal haven't been able to find the real number of patients owing to a weak health system. Pakistan, which claims that its lower numbers are due to its smart lockdown strategy, has been opposed by observers, saying that the results have been so due to misreporting and inadequate testing.
A growing anti-establishment resistance in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir has unnerved Islamabad. It has unleashed barbarity to muzzle the voices of dissenters. Tanveer Ahmed, an activist and journalist from Dadiyal city in POK, was brutally thrashed and jailed for daring to call Pakistan an occupier and removing Pakistan's flag from a public place. And this wasn't an isolated incident. Anybody who has dared raised his voice against the Pakistani discrimination and human rights violation in the region has been subjected to violence, imprisonment, exile, or even death in some cases.
While these few second visuals are enough to shake human conscience, such scenes have become an everyday phenomenon in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. Tanveer Ahmed, a journalist and activist, was dragged on for several meters before being dumped in a police vehicle. Tanveer was on a hunger strike for days and had demanded local authorities to remove Pakistani flags from a public space, failing in which he himself removed the flags. In a secretly filmed video inside his detainee room, Tanveer said that police had brutally beaten him for daring to stand against what was wrong. The incident has sparked outrage across the Pakistan-occupied region, and a number of demonstrations have been carried out demanding his release. The protests are gaining momentum with people from all sections of society joining in. The people say police also arrested the youths who had raised slogan against Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan. Exiled Kashmiri leaders and activists are mulling to hold demonstration across Europe against police high-handedness, which they say has become a regular phenomenon in the region.
It's high time that the authorities in Pakistan as well as in Muzaffarabad understand and realize the dangers that accompany such acts of terror. If these acts are not remedified, then things may escalate. We are in the process of consultation at the moment to organize a series of demonstrations across the globe to condemn these police excesses. If it is not addressed, then things will escalate and the responsibility would lie on the people of, on the government of Muzaffarabad as well as the responsible people of Pakistan.
Pakistan's insecurity against Kashmiri activists, both political and social, has manifested in its extrajudicial operations over the years. It has preemptively targeted and suppressed the voices demanding rights and freedom in its illegally occupied regions of POK and Gilgit-Baltistan. Baba Jan is one among the hundreds who have been targeted by Pakistani forces. Baba Jan has been languishing in jail for years now. Tanveer Ahmed too has joined the same list. Locals fear even if he is released in some days, the establishment will continue to haunt him for years through its suppressive political instruments.
Next, we move to India to witness this year's celebrations of Ganesh Chaturthi, the most awaited festival in the southern and western parts of the country. Celebrated in the honor of Hindu Lord Ganesha, also regarded as the god of wisdom, the festival is a complete mixture of culture, history and vibrancy. Though the festival is observed in a grand manner, but this year, amid the pandemic, its celebrations were kept a low-key affair.
Huge idols of Lord Ganesha, crowded tents and chants of Ganpati Bappa Moria reverberating in the air. All this marks the celebrations of the most resplendent festivals of Ganesh Chaturthi in India. Every year, people set up huge pandals, a temporary shed where they install a beautifully crafted idol of the elephant-headed god. But this time, due to coronavirus outbreak, they were erected at very few places and allowed the entry of limited devotees to avoid the spread of infection. In Western Mumbai city, a religious body like every year erected a pandal but didn't compromise with safety. It installed sanitizer and temperature measuring machines and urged people to properly follow the social distancing norms.
ज़्यादा भीड़ न होने देने की जी जो तैयारियां है वो मंडल की तरफ से की गई है मंडल की तरफ से इस बार 4 फीट के गणपति की स्थापना यहां की गई है और ज्यादा से ज्यादा सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग से दर्शन लेने की कोशिश मंडल की हो चुकी है और इसे भी हम मंडल की तरफ से आह्वान कर रहे हैं कि आप घर बैठ के एकदम सुरक्षित रीति गणपति का दर्शन लीजिए.
Taking a step towards environment protection, people adopted for eco-friendly Ganesha idols. In Ludhiana, a chocolate Ganesha, which was made out of 40 kilograms of Belgian chocolate, drew many eyeballs. The idol was created in 10 days with the collective effort of 10 chefs and looked simply marvelous. The festivities of Ganesh Chaturthi go on for 10 days. And on the last day, the idols are taken through these streets in a procession, accompanied by dancing and singing, and later immersed in a river or the sea.
According to the Hindu mythology, the elephant god Ganesh is a Vignaharta, the one who eliminates evil powers. With that, we come to the end of this week's episode. See you next week. Goodbye and take care.